Hey, Dallas, thanks for waiting while I took a break, and I came back with Boone Smith. You know him as the guy that loves cats on TV. He's really good with them. Well, he's going to talk about what he's been up to. Boone Smith, welcome back to the Balder Beebe Show here live in Dallas, Texas.
Hey, thanks for having me back.
Okay, what have you been up to? I know you're so busy with those big cats.
Yeah, we've been pretty busy. You know, the Big Cat Week kicks off here this Friday, 9 p.m., you know, we've got a great lineup of different shows of big cats from all over the globe. You know, lions, tigers, leopards, you name it, it's going to be there. So we're really excited for that, you know, to be coming out again.
Okay. When you say, did you travel to far off destinations like you usually do? Where did you go to give us this Big Cat Week?
Yeah, you know, we're all over the globe on this one. The shows that I participated in this year, we headed to South Africa. We had a big focus this year on African lions. Man v. Lion actually kicks off Big Cat Week this year at 9 p.m. on Nat Geo Wild. And we've got a really unique show there. We're going to highlight lions, some of the skill sets they have, the things that make them really unique. And we're going to give folks a point of view of lions that they probably haven't seen before.
You've got a very different career. I guess from us looking from outside in, and I'm sure you know a lot of people in your field, but you've been doing this 20 years. You do cougars and pumas and lions. So how is it living your dream? Because this has to be a dream. This is not a job you just signed up for.
Yeah, it's, you know, I mean, it's a passion. I mean, it's something I absolutely love to do. I've been very blessed and fortunate in my life to be able to have some really unique and amazing experiences. And you know, I mean, it's great. The cause that I work for, to collar different cats and track them, I mean, for the conservation and research, you know that the job we're doing and the data we collect goes to better the species and help them out and make sure they're managed correctly. And, you know, it's a good feeling at the end of the day to know that even if in a small way, I'm helping make a difference.
Okay, tell me about Future Cat, because you told me about what you've done and in the past. I love that. But what's the future as predicted for some of these species? I know has to be on the endangered list.
Yeah, you know, I mean, that's kind of the sad part of it when we talk about some of the big cats. You know, I'll give you two examples. Tigers are kind of our poster child for an endangered cat that is, it's on the brink. It's we need to act now and we need to do something fast or that's going to be a species that is going to disappear. There's more tigers in captivity than there are in the wild. And that's a pretty telling statement. African lions, the show the animal we highlight in Man v. Lion. Here's an animal that over the last 40 years, their population has decreased by 90%. You know, there's 30,000 left roughly, and that's not endangered, but yet that's obviously a very significant and dramatic decline. And it really goes to show that we need to be proactive at this point. We don't need cats to become endangered and fight the fight to try and get them back. We need to do things now, make sure that we have proper management, conservation decisions being made to make sure that these cats are there in healthy numbers for a long, long time. They're important to our ecosystem and our environment. We need to have them there.
Boone, we have a Facebook post. One of the posts for you is, how can we, ordinary people who do not get to the wild, how can we make a difference? Ooh, that was a good question.
That's a fantastic question. Yeah, you know, not everyone needs to go out there and catch and radio collar cats for certain.
That's why we got you.
Yeah. You know, the easiest way I can recommend people to do it is you can go to National Geographic's website. They've got a couple great programs. The Cause and Uproar program, which is kind of what we focus on in this Big Cat Week, the Create an Awareness campaign, and the Big Cats Initiative. These are two programs run by National Geographic that it's where people can donate. You can buy shirts, cups, different things. There's great facts that are on the websites there. And the great thing about these projects is the money and things that people donate and contribute to, they go to right there on the ground projects. So these go to radio callers, these go to education programs, these go to the things that we need right now to happen for lions and tigers and leopards and all these different species to make sure that we're making a difference.
Well, Boone Smith, you've got such a wonderful job, but you're the poster child for our 21st century cat lover. Did you know that?
Well, that's good. That's great.
That's a good thing. It's a really good
thing.
Okay. Okay, so you're kicking off Big Cat Week. You got us because most of us are going to be off. We can actually watch you on Nat Geo. Tell me what time and when.
Yeah, so it's Friday night, 9 p.m. Nat Geo Wild kicks it off, and then from there on out the rest of the week, it's Big Cats, Big Cats, Big Cats.
Well, you're a big cat in our little world, Boone Smith. Thank you so very much for coming on the Valder Beebe Show once again.
Yeah, thank you, Valder.